This could be yours. 30 acres of land in Hardwick, Vermont, looking out at farms and mountains. A large home, complete with fountains, swimming pool, and room for animals. All being sold to punish a criminal.
You want to hit them in the pocketbook, where they're really going to hurt the most.
48-year-old Ronald Aldrich, seen here as a younger man, was sentenced in 2007 to 14 years in federal prison. At the time, the judge called his marijuana smuggling scheme the largest he'd seen. Prosecutors described literally tons of pot brought from Canada into Vermont, sometimes hidden in shipments of grain.
Criminals are looking at ways to be creative in order to beat the system.
That includes, the U.S. Marshals Service says, laundering profits from the pot smuggling by investing in this property relatives had built. Court records show a sale price of $200,000 to Aldrich, or Ronnie Cash, as he was known on the streets. After his conviction, prosecutors say the smuggler forfeited well over $1 million in assets, including the estate. It goes up for bids next Wednesday with a minimum price of $70,000.
This is a relatively rare event.
But whoever buys the property has to agree to one really big caveat. The drug smuggler's mother and stepfather still live in the property, and the government is going to let them stay for as long as they want for the rest of their lives.
We're in good health now. I'm planning to be here for a while, you know, certainly.
Bill Hill remembers his stepson claimed he got the money through an insurance settlement for an injured ankle.
I guess I'm gullible. Somebody tells me something, I believe him.
For however long he wants to be here, Hill, not the buyer, will have to maintain the property and pay the taxes and insurance. Hill says he never suspected his home was funded with drug money.
I disowned him, but I didn't know what he was doing.
The feds hope buyers see this as a good investment, betting the land will appreciate in value. The Marshal Service says proceeds from the auction will go toward combating crime. In Hardwick, Jack Thurston, News Channel 5.